Most of the migrants here have left countries with few jobs and limited prospects. This is their alternative. Young men, but also teenage girls and children. Samuel has fled from Boko Haram Islamist militants.
No problem, I have to take the risk. You know, when you want to achieve something, you have to risk. Yes, that's why I prefer to go to Europe.
Even to risk your life?
It's God who has the last word. I must make it for my family.
Hello, welcome to my channel once again. I thank you so much for supporting my channel, watching my videos, commenting, liking and all that. I thank you and I really, really appreciate. If you don't know my name is Kamma Dyn, and today I am bringing you top 5 reasons why Africans travel to the Americas, Europe, India, China, and even the Arab countries. You know, I get some African Americans asking that we are calling them to come to Africa, but why is it that Africans are also traveling to the Americas, the Europe, and all these places? So stay tuned and let's get into the video. So my number one reason is going to be education. You know, some of these Africans that travel abroad, they get scholarships to study abroad and they go there, and whilst they are in school, they work at the same time schooling. So that's basically what they do. Some of them too, their parents have money, so they go there basically, they take them there basically to study abroad. And you know, in Africa we have this perception that when you travel outside or when you travel abroad and you go there to learn, basically you are seen as like a special person. I don't even know how to even put it, but you are seen differently and they rate you high, you know, they rate you high basically. So that's one particular reason why I'm sure so many Africans travel to abroad and they just go there to study. My number two reason is unemployment. Unemployment rate in Africa, or let me use Ghana for instance, is very huge. There are a lot of graduates, like unemployed graduates in Africa or in Ghana for instance, and they will go to school, the university for 4 years, they will come back. If you are not smart enough to create your own business, because in Africa, I always say the best thing for you to do is to create your own business. So if you are not able to do that, then meaning you are going to be stuck at one place. So unemployment is one thing. So you see Africans just gathering lots of money instead of perhaps using that money to set up a business for themselves. They use it for their trip, that's their plane tickets, their pocket money, their visas and everything. Then they travel because they know that when they go there, they are going to get jobs to do and they are going to be paid well, basically, you understand? So that's another reason why so many Africans travel abroad. Another reason that I'm going to give you is getting a well-paying paid job, because in Africa, how much are you being paid? Like for instance, if you are let me use this menial jobs that's like cleaning and washing and all these kinds of jobs. When you are doing these kinds of jobs in Africa, how much are you going to be paid? Let me use Ghana for instance. I am not aware of any cleaning job or you washing dishes in, let's say, restaurants that you are going to be paid more than 1,000 Ghana cedis. I don't know of any, or I have not heard of any job in Ghana, for instance, or in any other African country that you are going to be paid more than that. You see, so that is one reason why people just gather money. They just want to travel and get well-paying jobs, basically. Because if they travel abroad, they know that they are going to, even if they get these menial jobs without all these certificates and all that, they are going to get good jobs to do, and all these jobs to do, so that they are going to be paid well. You understand? 1,000 Ghana cedis, that's like less than even $100 now. That is even less than $100. Just imagine you living on $100. And that is like so many places, it's not even up to that $100. So that's the more reason why people travel abroad, just to get well-paid jobs to do, so that they can earn enough and build, like do something basically for their future. You understand? Because if I'm earning 1,000 Ghana cedis, how much am I going to spend within the month, and how much am I going to save, pay bills and all that? It's not easy. Exactly. So well-paid jobs is something that is another reason why so many Africans travel abroad to get well-paid jobs to do. Yes. My fourth point is going to be greener pastures. So many people are in Africa and they are working, they are trying so hard to work and earn something for themselves and perhaps build a better future for themselves, but the thing is not working. Like they've done all of the things that they are supposed to do, it is still not working. And even sometimes monies that they are supposed to get, so that they can even use it to travel, is also another thing. So you see many of them going through the Mediterranean Sea, go through the deserts, they pass through Libya to go to Spain, just for greener pastures. They go through a lot. Some of them even lose their lives on this desert or in the sea. And we've heard so many stories, and we've seen videos, we've seen, basically that's the thing, because it's like a do or die affair for them. Because Charlie, if you're a man, for instance, and you are living life and you are not even like, you are not really making any good ends meet, it's hard as a man, because you need to marry, you need to build a family in the future. How can you do that? So lots of them just pass through these deserts and these sea just to get to Spain, get to Portugal, get to Italy, so that they can be able to get jobs and earn something better for themselves. Because they've tried in Africa, they've tried and tried and tried, and it's not working for them. So that's another reason why Africans travel abroad. And my last point is going to be for a better future. We all know, if you are living life and you are in Africa, you are working, things are not really going well for you, how can you have a better future? How? Like, the thing is, like, the question is, how can you have a better future? You can never have a better future. You understand? So if there is the opportunity to go outside, work and come back, so basically they need a better life for the future. Because Charlie, and one thing that I like is that most of them, when they go, they come back, because the monies that you earn as your salary abroad, when you come back to Africa and you change them into the Ghana cedis and the Naira's and all the other currencies, or all the other African currencies, trust me, they are big money. They are huge amounts of money that you can buy properties, build houses, build your businesses, basically have a capital or any kind of business that you want to build. Because at that time, you have your capital, you can go into any business. And in Africa, you know that we have the numbers. So when you are able to get the right business and you invest in it, you are going to make a lot of money. And another thing is, you know, here, the freedom here and the weather and everything is so chill, like it's so cool that every day is summertime for us. So you are able to relax your mind. You are not like, You know, abroad, the weather alone, you don't live life and everything is like work, 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 work. So immediately you come back here or they come back here, they just relax, they free their mind, they do everything, anything that they want to do in Africa. So when they go, basically they work, they go through all the stress and all everything. They bring their monies here, they try to build some property, buy some properties, build businesses and all that, so that they will come here and retire. So basically that's the reason why Africans travel abroad, just to make ends meet, so that they will come back to Africa and invest. These are some of the things that I know. These are some of the reasons why I know that Africans travel outside. So if you are African American and you are wondering why Africans travel outside to Europe and all that, listen, in Africa or in Ghana, for instance, if you have money, if you have a well-paid job and you are comfortable, I tell you, it is the best place to live. Because most of these people, they will tell you abroad, it is not easy. You are like, it's just you trying to survive. You don't live life. So they try coming back all the time to just come and live life and enjoy life. That's basically what they do. So I thank you so much for watching my video. I thank you so, so much. Don't forget to like the video. Don't forget to subscribe. Comment whatever you want to comment and share the video for me. I thank you so much. Thank you.